discuss?
Well, frankly, put them out of business. And yes. This is from primary schools right through to most expensive public schools.
Wow, that's definitely something that isn't that people in this country, in the UK, are not so aware of. But there's another issue that's really pressing, I think, on people's minds at the moment, and that's the issue of smart meters, which you referred to earlier. That's something that seems to be sort of being brought into our homes, whether we like it or not. But there's many people who've got some concerns about whether this is a good idea.
Yes, and again, it's more developed, advanced perhaps in North America, but interestingly, the American Association of Environmental Medicine, again, just very recently, has called for a moratorium on the rollout of smart meters because of the whole question of irradiating, you know, an entire family all day long, 24/7. Pregnant women, infants, the elderly, the infirm. This technology has never been tested on.
Right.
And if it was a new drug, it would never get out of the laboratory. But the power companies and others, and vested interests, politicians included, seem to think that they can just expose us to it without us having any say on the matter, never mind the whole question of human rights.
So what
are there, there are various other dimensions to it, of a more sinister nature, people might want to be extremely concerned about.
So what are the sort of more sinister reasons, do you think, that might be possibly going on?
Well, besides the fact that people can hack into the system, burglars could hack in and obviously see when you're in and out in terms of planning robberies, there's some have brought up the fact that, in fact, they can image, using the Wi-Fi, can be used to image the people in the house and monitor their movements, monitor how many and who is in there, what they're doing, for whatever reasons.
So it's not just monitoring what gadgets and electronic devices you're using.
No. The potential is there for a far more Big Brother intrusion.
Right.
I mean, this is Big Brother writ large. I mean, right there in your home, able to, by a sort of equivalent of thermal imaging, see who's in, what they're doing, you know, in the kitchen, sleeping, watching TV. Security people would argue that it allows them to monitor those who need to be monitored, and if necessary, perhaps even kill them in a worst-case scenario if you're talking terrorists. But for the rest of us, the entire country, every single house, you are going to be exposed to this blanket radiation.
So there's a blanket radiation which we don't know is safe at all because it's never been tested, as well as this thermal imaging. So not only will we be able to tell what you're switching on, but actually what you're doing on your movements around the house. Gosh, that is very, very worrying. And it seems to be becoming compulsory as well, which is...
That's where the whole issue is debated, whether it should be mandatory, whether there should be alternatives, as this American environmental medicine report is saying, that perhaps the analog versions should be still offered and allowed. There will be arguments around that.
Yeah.
But there's, you know, potential legal action I've heard in the States going forward. So if they win any precedent cases, you can be sure that they'll start similar ones over here.
Right. Gosh. Yes, there's a lot of cause for concern there. With you yourself being such a pioneer in looking at these topics, years ago when you did write this book with Cyril Smith, you did highlight that electromagnetic fields of any sort actually have an effect perhaps on cell membranes. If we can look at the actual mechanisms by which EMFs could cause the damage that they do, could you talk a bit more about the effects that they have actually on living cells?
Well, research basically by people like Professor Ross Ady, Dr. Carl Blackman, Dr. Abe Liboff and others basically showed that they could affect the cell membrane permeability, which then of course changes what nutrients and other biochemicals enter and leave the cell. Mm-hmm. And they were particularly showed an effect on calcium efflux from cells.
Right. So permeability is how much water can come in and out of cells, which is very important for the cell's functioning.
Exactly. Permeability of that membrane is critical to what can pass in and out.
And of course, calcium influx is so critical for muscles and all sorts of functioning that happen in cells.
It would help explain memory loss and anxiety and sleeping problems and other effects, cognitive functioning or malfunctioning.
Yes.
You don't want calcium efflux from the brain, most certainly.
Exactly. So it's interesting.
And you don't want effects on the blood-brain barrier either, which again has been shown to be affected.
Absolutely.
So, yeah.
It seems that we've got research that goes back a long time. You know, the work of people like Robert Becker and Harold Saxton Burr, you know, who've been saying for a long time that, you know, fields actually do affect cells. And there's even some mainstream research that I've been looking at from the University of Aberdeen that actually says that stronger fields actually, from a team that's, this is a New Scientist, stronger fields actually encourage cells to divide. You know, so you really were pioneering, which of course, the stronger the fields, you know, the possibility is that the stronger the field, the more division of cells, and more division of cells, it may be leading to the cancer effects that we're actually seeing.
That would indeed, be a potential consequence.
Increase the
increase the rate of division and potential cancer effects. There's been a new study just by Dr. Hardell just a couple of months ago from Sweden, who's a major pioneer over the last 10 years, looking at mobile phone effects, and he's reporting increased acoustic neuromas and gliomas in the site of the face, etc.
What do you think will happen with 4G? Well, is that more dangerous?
I think potentially it certainly could be. It's also the chronic irradiation. You know, the body generally can recover from assaults, various environmental assaults, if given time to recover and regenerate. But where you're getting not only the immune system being chronically affected and debased, but in a home situation, if you're going to have Wi-Fi in your home, which I strongly advise against, and go back to a wired system for your computer systems, you're getting 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, while you're sleeping, irradiation. The body and the brain just cannot.
Are there any last comments you'd like to make for what people could do? Maybe not use Wi-Fi?
Well, certainly not use Wi-Fi in the home.
Right.
Not just for yourself, but for your children or pregnant wife or...
And resist smart meters.
Resist having smart meters. And particularly, though, for the children, again, in the schools, really educate your teachers.
Bring that in.
Okay. Make sure that they
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining us today. It's been most enlightening, and you've been doing so much work in this arena for so long. So thank you for all the work that you've been doing and for joining us today. Thank you.
Thanks. Okay.
Well, that's all we've got time for today, but thank you so much for joining us on Hidden Science. And make sure you join us next time as well, because we've been talking about lucid dreaming. So thank you and goodbye for now.